Thanks for just joining us. Delkat Vidyamandir Sukul Mass is being held right here at the Old Saints Cathedral, and of course other dignitaries have already started arriving, and many of them, the friends of Odelo Odinga as well, his workmates as well, his close friends as well, are here to celebrate the life of a man who has been described basically as one man who had scaled through, was not picky when it came to friends. He picked friends from any side of the political spectrum. He picked friends across the ethnic groups, and he was one who was a very jovial man who was able to cut across and be able to just speak to the masses. And whenever he entered the room, we are told, it would literally light up. Everybody would be happy and the same. Of course, the arrivals continue. As I told you, some of the people who have already arrived, some members of parliament allied to CORD, and of course, this procession that you are seeing now, just some of the arrivals that continue, as President Uhuru Kenyatta is also about to be here. Members from the diplomatic corps are also represented here as well, and also just arriving is the Attorney General, Githu Muigai, who has also just touched base there as the dignitaries continue to arrive here at the Old Saints Cathedral. Now, what is going to happen is once they arrive, as you can see there, there will be the opening prayer, of course. There will be a processional synthesis, the opening hymn, and then the eulogy will be read out. And then the tributes will then start flowing in. First will be his workmates, and also will be some of his friends and family as well. But right now, again, even as I run you through the program, the picture that you're seeing are the arrival of some of the key dignitaries, as well as, of course, President Uhuru Kenyatta. The CORD co-principal, Kalonzo Musyoka, has already arrived. And just arriving there is the brother to the former Prime Minister, Raila Odinga, who has arrived here. And they are going to be able to come. The pallbearers are here, are being called forth so that they can carry the remains of Fidel Castro Odhiambo Odinga into the cathedral, where they are going to continue with the prayers and the procession. Right now, though, members of the media being urged to simply give some little room so that they can continue with the processions here. Of course, we're coming to you, just in case you're joining us, from the All Saints Cathedral here in Nairobi. And just like I told you, some of the friends of Fidel Odinga have also arrived here. We're expecting there to be all these people to stand and basically give some of their last respects to him as well. So the picture that you are seeing there is the arrival of the body of Fidel Castro Odinga, accompanied by family members who are now here also to pay their last respects to him. Now, after that, there will be the spokesman who are also going to speak, one from the Odinga family, another one who has simply been indicated as in the program as Oyo, who are going to speak. And then from there, there's going to be a representative from the Orthodox Church who is also going to be able to speak. And then, as usual, the readings of the scripture, the first and second reading, will be there as well. So then there will be, of course, the offertory hymn and the word of thanks, but those are going to come a little bit later on. So, again, you can continue to follow some of these proceedings on at Citizen TV News and at Citizen TV Kenya. But again, the pictures that you're seeing, the body of the late Fidel Castro Odinga has arrived here at the Old Saints Cathedral, and the pallbearers are going to now carry it in to the hall where the service is being held. A lot of security, of course, here. And just like I had said a little bit earlier, there was a lot of, if you walk around here, you get a sense of people basically celebrating the life of Fidel Castro Odinga in little groups that were huddled around. Later, as I was walking by, what you could see here, Mahathir was talking about how he would enter into a place and everybody would laugh, how he was a very easygoing man. Some of them also groups remember he was the chair of the RUF, that is the rugby union of Kisumu. So some of those colleagues are here as well, talking about how he would give them a lot of morale, how he would support this, how he would support the sport. And so a really all-rounded individual Fidel Castro Odinga was. And some of them just relieving some of the last moments that they had with him. Most of them talking about how, you know, he was with them. He was a man who cared so much for the masses and for people. And basically also just saddened by the loss, and also sympathizing and empathizing with the family of former Prime Minister Kodinda Raila Amolo Odinga, because of course he, as any father would, had great hopes and expectations for his son. And those are some of the conversations that have been going on around here. Same thing on social media. If you look at social media, the hashtag RIP Fidel Odinga was pretty much the same. So the body is now being taken into the cathedral here at the All Saints, where it will be set right in front there for people to be able to pay their last respects to him. And then the procession, the service will begin. Right now, again, we are waiting for the arrival of the president. His arrival pretty much imminent. Some of the outriders are already beginning to come in, so that means that he is probably just around the corner, even as we wait to see. Just some of the songs I understand that are going to be sung today are also some of his favorite hymns and songs. Of course, there's some like Amazing Grace and some of the quotes that he had. He liked listening to music. He was also a businessman, and all these people have been represented here, and they are going to play to pay tribute and respects to him as well. Now, the president, Uhuru Kenyatta's arrival, as I say, is here, and so the president has now arrived at the venue. As President Uhuru Kenyatta has now arrived here at the Old Saints Cathedral. His outrisers and all have all come in now. And the car carrying the president is also here. So the picture we will get for you shortly. So there you have it. The president and his deputy are expected to be here, of course. Received by Raila Odinga, the court leader there. President Uhuru Kenyatta has arrived. There's President Uhuru Kenyatta there, just being received by the court leader's family. Of course, the cameraman and everybody clicking away to get the all-important shot. The mood, though, as expected, that of some president now is here to join the Requiem Mass of Fidel Castro Odinga. Now I am with my colleague Patrick Ingendi, who is also here holding fort as well, and I will hand over to him.
Baada ya wafu ya mwenda zake Fidel Castro Odinga, mwanawe kifungua mimba wa kinara wa CORD Raila Odinga. Ibada hii inafanyika hapa All Saints Cathedral, na tayari watu mbalimbali ama waombolezaji mbalimbali wamefika, ikiwa ni pamoja na Rais Uhuru Kenyatta. Mtazamaji, Fidel Odinga aliaga siku ya Jumapili kuamkia Jumapili tarehe 4 Januari nyumbani kwake seneta wa Karen, na Fidel Odinga, mtazamaji, ni mwanawe kifungua mimba kiongozi wa CORD Raila Odinga. Na watu mbalimbali ama waombolezaji mbalimbali wanaendelea kufika kuhudhuria ibada hii ya wafu ambayo ikishatamatika mwili unatarajiwa kusafirishwa hapo kesho hadi Kisumu, ambao kutaandaliwa ibada nyingine kwenye uwanja wa michezo wa Jomo Kenyatta, na kisha baadaye siku ya maziko ambayo ni Jumamosi ibada itafanyika katika ibada ya mazishi itafanyika katika chuo kikuu cha Jaramogi Oginga Odinga, kabla ya mazishi yenyewe kufanyika nyumbani kwake Odinga, Kango ka Jaramogi, ambako mazishi yatafanyika. Waliofika, mtazamaji, nikikuchorea taswira tu ni kwamba Rais Uhuru Kenyatta tayari amekwisha wasili, wana diplomasia mbalimbali, viongozi wa kidini, bila shaka kuna maseneta mbalimbali, kuna magavana mbalimbali, vile kuna wabunge, miongoni mwao wakiwa ni vinara wenzake Raila Odinga, yani Kalonzo Musyoka na Moses Wetangula. Mtazamaji, uchunguzi umekuwa ukiendelea kubaini hasa chanzo au kilichosababisha kifo cha Fidel Odinga, lakini kile kikosi ambacho kimekuwa kikiendesha uchunguzi huo kimeelezea kuwa kufikia sasa matokeo hayajabainisha haswa nini kilichosababisha kifo chake, na hivyo uchunguzi zaidi unahitajika. Naam, kwa sasa mtazamaji, unavyoona kwenye runinga yako ni kwamba mwili au jeneza lililobeba mabaki ya Fidel Castro Odinga unaingizwa pale kwenye mbele ya waombolezaji kanisani, All Saints Cathedral, ili ibada iweze kuanza kirasmi, ibada ya wafu kwa mwenda zake huyu ambaye watu wengi wamemtaja kuwa alikuwa kijana ambaye alikuwa shupavu, alikuwa kijana ambaye alikuwa mwingi wa uchangamfu kweli kweli. Mtazamaji, nitakupeleka moja kwa moja hadi yanayojiri ndani kanisani All Saints Cathedral, ili uweze kufuatilia ibada ya wafu ya mwenda zake Fidel Castro Odinga.
Tell the next generation that this is our God. Our God forever and ever. He himself will guide us up to death. Be faithful unto death, and I will give you a crown of life.
Brothers and sisters who have come for this service, Your Excellency, the family and friends who have come, we welcome you all to this service. The space may be crowded, but please take any place that you have quietly so that we can worship and glorify God in this service. Feel very welcome and be able to comfort each other as we mourn our son. Let's start by singing the first hymn, Amazing Grace. Choir.
Thank you. life of our brother Fidel Castro Odhiambo Odinga, whom the Lord has called to himself. Yet we believe that Jesus Christ died and rose again. So it will be for those who die in Christ, for God will bring them to with Jesus. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and this hope in us, that in all our days we may live like those who believe in the communion of saints and the forgiveness of sins and the resurrection of dead and eternal life. For everything there is a season, a time of every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silent and time to speak. Whilst standing, we'll hear the reading of the psalm.
We're reading from Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth gives way, though the mountains be moved into the heart of the seas, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God will help her when morning dawns. The nation reigns, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, and the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come, behold the works of the Lord. He has brought desolation on the earth. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the chariots with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress.
Please be seated. We have tried as much as possible to provide enough space. Those who are outside the church, please could you go to the auditorium? The auditorium and the main cathedral are linked in video and sound, and so you will be enjoying the service as if you are in the main cathedral. It is now my pleasure to invite the MC, who will take us through the tributes and the eulogy. MC.
grace, the Archbishop of the Anglican Church, the Orthodox Church, the Greek Orthodox Church, and the Coptic Orthodox Church, Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, Your Excellency, the Deputy President, the Right Honorable Prime Minister Raila Amolo Odinga and Mama Ida Odinga and the family, Members of Parliament present, Cabinet Secretaries, Judges, Permanent Secretaries and other State Officers, Members of the Diplomatic Corps, all protocols observed, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Otiende Amolo. I will be your MC for today. It is our desire to make this short as possible, but well deserved. So to start us off, we will start by reading of the eulogy. May I invite Winnie Odinga to come and read the eulogy.
Hello everybody. I'm here to read the eulogy. Here at this final hour, we have come to bid farewell to a bright hope extinguished now, but only physically gone from us forever. Before I proceed with the eulogy, I wanted to say that, you know, funerals are very sad affairs, but I don't want this to be a sad affair. I want us to celebrate the life of my brother. So even the speakers that come after me, I know I might seem a bit sad, but I'd like us to continue in the celebratory mood and make this a good send-off for my brother. Fidel Odinga was born on November 2nd, 1973, at Mater Hospital, Nairobi, the firstborn child to Dr. Ida Betty Odinga and the Right Honorable Raila Odinga. He was the protector of three younger siblings, Rosemary Akeo, Raila Jr., and myself, Winnie M. Good. I like the use of the word protector, because he was our protector. You know, I remember a few years ago when I was seeing somebody, and he said, "You know, Kazi, my friends call me Kazi. They don't call me Winnie." And he said, "You know, Kazi, dating you is a very hard affair." And I said, "Why? Is it because my father is the Prime Minister?" And he said, "Yeah, but not really." And I said, "Is it because I have a driver and a bodyguard?" And he said, "Yeah, but not really." So I thought, and I said, "Is it because I've been raised by such a strong woman and I've been taught to be independent?" And he said, "Yeah, but not really." I said, "So what is it?" And he said, "Because if I so much as breathe the wrong words to you, I know you have a 6'6" brother that will come and lynch me by the ears." And that was Fidel. He was our protector. Him and I had 17 years age difference. 17 years, same mother, same father. I don't know much about raising kids, but to raise children from 1973 up until the day I turned 18, 2008, it's like 35 years. I mean, that's something impressive. Please clap for my friends. That's something you can't just do. Fidel attended Kilimani Junior Academy in Nairobi and thereafter transferred to Consolata School, also in Nairobi, to complete his primary education. He proceeded to Mbeji Academy in Siaya, where he undertook and completed his secondary education. On completion of his secondary schooling, Fidel traveled to India to begin his university education. A year later, he transferred to Prairie View A&M University in Texas and then to Southeastern University in Washington, D.C., where he studied business. Fidel married Veronica in 2007, but the couple decided to split ways in 2011. On July 27, 2012, in a beautiful ceremony in Nairobi, Fidel married Luan Bekele in the Coptic Church. Exactly a year after their marriage, also on July 27, 2013, Fidel and Luan were blessed with a son, Alai Raila Odinga. Alai brought joy to his parents, and Fidel was a committed family man who loved his wife and always doted over Alai, frequently sending photos and videos of their son to his family members and friends. After living in the United States of America, Fidel returned to Kenya in 2002, where he developed and ran many successful businesses. As a young man before he went to university, Fidel had a very close relationship with his grandfather, the late Jaramogi Oginga Odinga. Fidel was a constant companion, foot soldier, and student of his father, learning a lot from him on life and politics. On his return to Kenya from university, Fidel picked up from where he left and was readily available to help in his father's political endeavors, frequently seen towering behind his father at political rallies. Fidel was an ardent sports fan. He was the chairman of Kisumu RFC and a staunch supporter of Gor Mahia and Arsenal football clubs. Fidel loved music, especially reggae and Ohangla. He was a voracious reader and was always studying other cultures such as the Rastafari culture, even traveling to Jamaica to visit Bob Marley's grave at Nine Mile. I'll share a small story with you here. I remember my sister reminded me a few days ago when we went to Jamaica. We went to Bob Marley's grave at Nine Mile, and Fidel knew everything. Fidel, the tour guide was taking us around. Fidel knew everything. It reached a point that the tour guide told Fidel, "Hey, you're making my job a lot easier. Why don't you come and be the tour guide?" And Fidel laughed, and we went on. But still in the back, Fidel was still, he was still my tour guide as we walked along. And, I mean, he loved Bob Marley, and I have to say that. So I'll finish with a Bob Marley quote. "The winds that sometimes take something we love are the same that bring us something we learn to love. Therefore, we should not cry about something that was taken from us. But yes, love what we have been given, because what is really ours is never gone forever." Thank you.
Fidel worked with many people in many sectors, in business and in communities. One of the most recent initiatives he was engaged in before his demise was an initiative called Eco Green Auto Clean, which involved a group of young people. I will invite one of their representatives to give his tribute. May I now invite Victor Winners to please come forward and give a very short tribute to Fidel. Victor Winners, please.
To Honorable Raila Odinga, the bereaved family, friends, and all protocols observed, we are the Eco Green Auto Clean Management Team, a company that was pioneered with the late Fidel Castro Odinga. Our main aim is environmental conservation and youth empowerment. The late Fidel Castro Odinga was our chairman. Not only was he a mentor, inspiration, role model, besides an ally, it was his dream to see a better Kenya, where there were more job opportunities and a conducive environment for me and you. The company was to be launched on the 22nd of this month, but unfortunately, death took him away. We are passionate and optimistic to carry out his legacy and to ensure the vision he had is fulfilled. Indeed, a great soul has departed, but the memories shall never fade. Your loss is huge, and we share your pain. May the late Fidel Castro Odinga rest in peace until we meet again. Thank you.
Thank you, Victor. Fidel had many friends. As you all know, his friends cut across ethnicities, regions, and political parties. There are many clusters of friends, but we will only invite one of them to give a short tribute to Fidel. May I invite Joshua Omino, if you are close by, to please come and give a short tribute to Fidel. Joshua Omino, please. As he's preparing to come, oh yes, John Nyaga will actually do that on behalf of the friends. Odinga family. Good afternoon. The Odinga family, as friends, want to let you know that we're with you. Even before I start the tribute, Your Excellency, all protocols observed. Thank you for being here. As friends of Fidel Castro Odinga, we would like to thank you for coming to celebrate his life and to share our grief in his passing. FCO, Cashflow, Castro, Macarius, Gagolo, Obange, Top Luo, TRL, aka Top Ranking Luo. We all had countless nicknames for you, a testament to how many lives you touched. We write this with great sadness over the unimaginable loss of a close friend and a dear brother. Fidel was loving and real. He was tall and commanding. He had a great sense of humor. And in fact, there were many times he would simply adopt a foreign accent and speak mockingly and put us all in laughing fits just to accommodate who you were. We remember how, when he came from his trip from Jamaica, it became all that he could speak about. And interestingly, for a time after this, his fashion and facts became all things Jamaica. Fidel was definitely a man of diverse interests, and even more so, a connector of people. He made us come together. Fidel was a generous friend, gave unselflessly of his time and of himself. He was also a philanthropist in his own way, helping those in less fortunate times, whether it was donating water tanks in the villages in Kibera, or at a harambe, maybe somewhere in the Kiambu County, or inspiring and empowering the youth in Bondo, which he loved dearly. What we know is that, Fidel, what you have done for others and the world will remain and is immortal. Fidel, the lives you touched, thank you. And you live, and through these acts of kindness, you shall be with us. Fidel was unmistakably and proudly at ease with himself. Castro was authentic. He was a dynamic individual, moving seamlessly, as you all know, from expensive suits to Air Maxes, Jordans, from listening to reggae, rap, hip-hop, and especially for his love for Kenyan music. We all remember calling Fidel's phone, and you'd hear, "Oh, you know, Missy Annie's tune." And on many occasions, you would hear him singing or just humming along to this as he daydreamed. He adopted to every environment, and this is what endeared him to so many. He was a lover of fun times, a regular at reggae music concerts, sports tournaments. His love and passion for music was evident to all. It was not often that you could mess with his car radio, and all who were in his car knew that was a no-go zone. Let's not forget that he was a dedicated watcher of football, and like most Arsenal fans, was very resilient and a hard-working supporter. And anyone who knew Fidel and knows him well probably has been pulled to Nyayo Stadium to watch Gor Mahia matches. And it was VIP all the way. And you'd normally kit us all the way from uniform and things like that. As friends, we are struggling with the loss of our friend. We probably will continue to try to come to terms with what has happened for a while longer. But we will still know that, but we will be still and know that there is a God. He is king over the storm that we are going through. For today,
may cry. For there is sacredness in tears. They are not the mark of weakness, but the mark of power. They speak more eloquently than 10,000 tongues. They are the messengers of overwhelming grief and unspeakable love for Fidel Castro. We know that Fidel would have wanted with all his heart to remain united forever with his family and his loved ones. So, as friends, we want to say to the Odinga family, Luam, it takes much soul searching to accept when death comes totally unexpectedly. He was just talking with you, holding you, joking with you, comforting you just the other day. And without explanation, Castro is gone. We know that our lives are forever changed. To you, we offer our utmost condolences. The angels are always near to those who are grieving, to whisper to them that their loved ones are safe in the hand of God. Remember always that you raised an exceptional man. We are proud to have called him a friend. And to Alai and Luam, you are not alone. We promise to always be there for you, the both of you. So please call on us whenever you need us. Alai, we will be there for you. As you transition from a boy to a young man, we will remind you of who your father was and the virtues he stood for. What a great man he was. We will be there to pick you up when it is not always easy to understand why he left you at such a young age. Even though you are no longer here, Fidel Castro Odinga, each one of us promise to pass on. Finally, if there is one thing Fidel taught us, is that life is short. So in the words of the ever-great Bob Marley, who he lived by most of his words, love the life you live. Live the life you love. Till we meet again, rest in peace, my brother, Fidel Castro Odinga. God bless. My name is Joe Nyaga, and this is Jeff Kiboro. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Joe and Jeff. We have a special tribute from His Excellency retired President Mwai Kibaki, and this tribute will be read by Senator Paul Kimani Wamatangi of Kiambu.
Your Excellencies, the President, Rumegai Kenyatta, and the Deputy President, the parents of the late Fidel, former Prime Minister Raila Odinga, and Mama Aida, and Fidel's widow. On my own behalf, and on behalf of my family, first I want to express my sincere condolences. I'm also here to read on behalf of the third President, His Excellency Mwai Kibaki, his message of condolence to the family. Honorable Raila and Aida Odinga, message of condolence upon the passing on of your son Fidel. We all prayed and wished to have a great and peaceful 2015. Therefore, there could not possibly be a more challenging moment at the outset of this year, as you were thrust by the sudden loss of your beloved son, Fidel Odinga. a young man I had known for a good number of years. The pain of this loss stings even more because the young man we now mourn was at the cusp of his glorious years. Before him was a horizon of numerous opportunities. It was not lost to me that at the point of his demise, Fidel, on whom great expectations were duly invested by both the family and scores of Kenyans, seemed to have begun upscaling his interest and involvement in public affairs, specifically in politics and in sports, particularly rugby. As we mourn Fidel and reflect upon the special role he must have played in completing the Odinga family, I pray that his siblings find peace in the fact that their brother was well regarded by peers across Kenya's socio-cultural profiles, a testament of the big persona he carried. To his parents, take solace in that you brought up a man of the people, who was ready to get his hands dirty and who got along well with just about anyone, itself one of the traits that distinguished Fidel from his contemporaries. As we bid him farewell, Fidel's hopes, dreams, and aspirations are worthy of note and follow-up, as they represent the person he ultimately wished to become. My sincere condolences go to Raila Odinga's family, Fidel's wife and child, friends, relatives, and Kenyans in general. Signed, Mwai Kibaki, CGH, the third president of the Republic of Kenya on 7 January 2015.
Fellow mourners, as we continue, let me make two announcements. First is that because of the capacity of the church, we are using two venues, one venue but two different places simultaneously. There are as many of us in the auditorium out there as we are in church following this service. We thank them for the patience they have shown while there. Secondly, may I urge fellow mourners that whatever the urge you may have to condole with the family during this solemn service, or to greet His Excellency the President or the Deputy President, or any of the other fellow mourners, please withhold it until we are done with this service. Allow me, mourners, to now invite the Senate Minority Leader and Senator for Bungoma, Senator Moses Wetangula.
Our brother, Prime Minister Raila Odinga, Mama Ida, the widow of our departed son, Fidel, Excellency the President, Deputy President, Governor of Nairobi, Speaker of the National Assembly, Deputy Speaker of the Senate, and distinguished mourners, I stand here with a heavy heart to condole the family of our brother Raila Amolo Odinga. Fidel, as his first son, has been to all of us like a brother to his father. Very rarely do you find Raila Amolo Odinga in any public place or public function without Fidel by his side. be it a social event, be it a political event, he was always there. On the first of this year, I came back to Nairobi, and on arrival, Prime Minister Raila called me and asked me to go with him to watch football. Him and I and many other Kenyans are the long-suffering fans of Arsenal Football Club that has not been doing very well. We met in Westlands, Nairobi, and our team for sure was given a thrashing by some other known team. We stayed on to watch a second match between Chelsea and Tottenham. And our spirits were rejuvenated when Tottenham thrashed Chelsea. Because, as you know, fans of Arsenal will always cheer any team playing Man U or Chelsea. And Fidel joined us, had a drink with us, and excused himself and left to go and meet his friends elsewhere. On Sunday morning, I received a phone call as I was entering church in Bungoma town. And the news I got was devastating. A distraught voice from my brother Raila simply said, "Fidel is no more." I tried to ask him a few questions, but I had gotten the message. And social media started flashing news all over. What followed are events that we all know. We stand here to pay tribute to a young man that has left an indelible mark on the length and breadth of our country, an indelible mark on the minds of each people he has interacted with. We've seen him at football, we've seen him at rugby, we've seen him at political rallies, we've seen him everywhere. And he always had a smile for everybody. Many great people have passed on at very early ages. Our Savior Jesus died at the age of 33. He's been remembered across the universe to date. His great hero, Bob Marley, died at only 36. He's remained a legend. We know many people who die at 90, and you can't describe them in even one sentence as to what they did. Fidel has left as a legend in his own right in everything that he did. We stand here as the Code Fraternity, on my own behalf, my family, my colleagues from Parliament, and all Kenyans of goodwill, to pray for the family, wish Brother Raila and Mama Ida the strength and the cover of the blood of Jesus, for you to go through this very trying moment, because we know, all things being equal, every parent wishes that his death precedes his children so that they can bury him. But we also know that God is the great decider. And when he makes his decision, we remain helpless, but only thank him for the opportunity he gave us to live with our loved ones. We celebrate the life of Fidel, We salute his parents for having brought Fidel to be with us. And we thank God for having given us that gift. May the good Lord rest his soul in eternal peace. Fare thee well till we meet, because that is the journey for all of us. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Wetangula. May I now invite former Vice President, Excellency Kalonzo Musyoka.
Raila Amolo Odinga, dada yangu Aida, mjane na mtoto wetu Noam, na kijana ambaye ako na umri tu wa mwaka moja na nusu, Raila Odinga Junior, Mheshimiwa Rais Uhuru Kenyatta, Mheshimiwa Naibu wa Rais ndugu William Ruto, waombolezaji wenzangu. Katika wakati huu mgumu zaidi wa majonzi, tuomba Mungu awape familia na wananchi wote wa Kenya subira, hasa tukijua kwamba kama alivyotamka rais mstaafu kwa risala yake, mwanzo wenyewe umekuwa mwaka umekuwa mgumu zaidi, hasa kwa familia ambayo ndugu yetu Raila. Allow me to paraphrase words that have been famously quoted of Brutus, for those of us who have been familiar with the works of Shakespeare, who actually lived through time. And Brutus famously said at the funeral of Julius Caesar, but from coming to bury Caesar, saying a lot of other things about the evil and the good that people do while they're alive, that follows them. But he actually said famously that the elements were so juxtaposed in him that nature could stand up and say, here was a man. I think we can say the same about Fidel. I know that because he's Raila Odinga's son, he seems not to have grown, but this young man grew tall, at 6 foot, what did Winnie say? 6'7", or thereabouts. Could have been a world player if he wasn't playing rugby. Could have joined the Basketball Association anytime, and could have done well. He literally stood for what is good in our country. Without knowing political boundaries and other kinds of boundaries, man-made inhibitions, Fidel was able to reach out to all of us. I said yesterday, and allow me to repeat, that as we sit here today, to say kwaheri to Fidel, isn't it amazing that the whole nation is here? Mr. President is here. Opposition is here. Is it difficult, if we truly loved Fidel, for us as a nation to say 2015, we shall follow this young man's example of dialoguing and sit together and ask ourselves some basics rather than having to fight each other in parliament, in the courts of justice, over matters that we can, as Kenyans, very ably sit together and discuss. Because the future is for the likes of Fidel, young, exuberant. But you know, I say that 41, not so young, the late Tom Mboya made such a big mark at 39, and the nation came to a standstill. I remember it because as a little boy in Form 2 in 1969, Fidel was 41.
a leader in his own right. Therefore, I want to urge all of us to really live this spirit of reaching out, dialoguing. This is what, if you allow me, we have actually been calling for on the other side of the political divide. We mean no ill. We're only guided by what is in the best interest of all of us. Finally, I know my brother Musa likes to talk about Arsenal and Raila and how they were defeated. I actually watched the same match. And it was Southampton which helped you over Chelsea. But let me tell you, I would rather we really as Kenyans now also transfer this passion about love for sport like Fidel, even to support our very own, like Harambee Stars. Of course, my team is Sofapaka. Always kupigana na watoto wa Mungu. And so this is it. Wonderful. Because Winnie, I'm encouraged by Winnie, because she said we should celebrate this. We shouldn't really mourn. Wonderful. The rest of you in the family should feel comforted that Fidel's name will never be forgotten. Fidel, Castro, Macarios, Odhiambo, Odinga. Five long names. And yesterday I made a request to the governor of Mombasa who felt he could name one street after Fidel. And I said, don't be shy. Name, just write the full five names so the history will say, just like Fidel stood so tall, his name is also the tallest. And that will be a memorial for all of us. To say when we do good and we try to unite our country, this nation and generations to come will remember us. I know Macarios came through here, wonderful good friend of Mzee Jomo Kenyatta when he was being exiled to Seychelles. And I know that His Eminence Bishop Macarios is here. He baptized him. And I know his father will talk about the rest of it. And one thing, it's not even Greek Orthodox Church, it's the Orthodox Church in Kenya, showing that even at the level of religious associations, we have others that have come in and also demand recognition. Allow me to pay tribute to His Eminence Macarios for the wonderful work he has done in this country and for having baptized Fidel as Macarios. I will have occasion, hopefully, to speak a bit more. I don't really want to take any more of my fellow mourners' time. May the good Lord rest the soul of Fidel in everlasting life. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to now invite His Excellency, the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya, William Samoei Ruto, to give his tribute.
Thank you very much. Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, Honorable Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, the widow of our friend Fidel Castro Odhiambo Macarios Odinga, Luam and your son, the former Prime Minister Raila Amolo Odinga, Mama Aida, distinguished leaders present here, fellow mourners. I bring condolences from my wife and children, to the family of our friend Raila Amolo Odinga and his family on the passing on of this great Kenyan, Fidel Odinga. I must admit that Fidel Odinga was a young Kenyan. great heart, a promising future, and had tremendous opportunity, and held a lot of promise for our great nation. His passing on is not only a loss to his wife and family and parents, it's a loss to the wider Kenyan family that we all belong. Twice last year, Fidel Castro called me and came to see me in the office. And I agree with those who have said that he went beyond borders. He breached many borders, and he was a free Kenyan. It is said that a man's character is judged by the company he keeps. If you look at the company Fidel Odinga kept, you will know that he was a true Kenyan at heart. People from all communities and all religions and all regions were friends to Fidel Odinga. And even as we speak, in his funeral, he is speaking to us, Kenyans, that we can, as the people of Kenya, be one beyond tribal or regional barriers. That is one thing that Fidel Odinga, from wherever he is, in the hands of God, is speaking to us. And because of that message, that's why we are assembled here from across the political divide, from every corner of our country, to bid farewell to this great Kenyan. And therefore, from me and my family, it's our very sincere prayer to Luam and Fidel's son, and to the family of Fidel, that God in his own way will see you through this trying moment and execute the plan that he has beyond Fidel being with us. May God rest his soul in eternal peace. Thank you.
Fellow mourners, ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the part of the family. Allow me to invite the eldest in the family, an honorable member of the National Assembly, Dr. Oburu Oginga, to conduct this part.
His Excellency the President of the Republic and the Deputy President and all protocols observed. I'm standing up here to say a few words on behalf of the family of Odinga. Jaramogi Oginga Odinga was our father and grandfather to Fidel. But before I say a word or two, I would like to invite my nephew, who was Fidel's brother, Junior Raila Kimbo, to come and say a word or two. Junior Karibu.
His Excellency, the President, Republic of Kenya, Honorable Uhuru Kenyatta. His Excellency, Deputy President of Kenya, Honorable William Ruto. All protocols observed. I'm here with my assistant today, Safi. She had wanted to come here today and just say something small about her uncle, her favorite uncle. Safi, did you want to say something?
He was by my side whenever I was sad. He would always give me a big smile.
Thank you, Safi. Thank you. I prepared a speech earlier, which I'd wanted to say, but most stuff had already been said. But because I'd prepared it, I guess I'll just go over it again. For those of you who didn't hear, my speech is on behalf of the siblings. So we are gathered here today in memory of my brother Fidel, so that together we may acknowledge and share both our joy in the gift that was his life and the pain that his passing brings. Fidel was more than a brother to us. He was our protector, a unifier, a guiding light, family clown, and disciplinarian. When we were younger, Fidel would probably be a general in the army if he wasn't an Odinga. When we were younger, Fidel would make us stand at attention. Those of you who remember BOK at 4 o'clock, there was just before the news, there was the national anthem, and Fidel would make us stand at attention as he goes marching around the living room. That was Fidel. Fidel was dedicated to family and had a special place in the hearts of his relatives. On the day of my wedding, Fidel went to pick up my wife Yvonne and insisted in his own words, he's not living without his brother's wife. Despite the reluctance of the Kubikosias and the Gashukias, his dedication to family even extended to him, half threatening a would-be suitor of his niece Camille. That young man was very, very scared after he met Fidel. Through Fidel, we got to know a good number of our relatives, as he made a point of knowing all our cousins and relatives in Sakwa, Game, and beyond. To say Gagolo was a friend to many is an understatement. His diverse circle of friends enriched not only his life, but ours as well. We thank his friends for being his other families and for the love and color you added to his life and ours. Like most of us, Gagolo was human and he had his own flaws. Indeed, it would be a myth if we portrayed him as a saint. One thing we can agree, though, is that he had a big heart, at times to a fault. The physical and emotional scars that Fidel bore are testimony to the fact that he loved life and ate it with a big spoon. Be it from chasing rosemary around the house in Kelelashwa and sliding into a glass door in the process, falling off a guava tree in Migori and being rescued by an ambulance, which was a wheelbarrow being pushed by Bill, to his later well-documented escapades, I think. Fidel only knew one speed. Fidel was a trendsetter, as was evidenced by the fact that he was the only child in the family back in the 80s with curly kid. He was also known to be the first kid with a chopper bicycle with gears. His love of toys and tools extended to his adult life as evidence of his passion for his cars, his watches, and his licensed firearms. Fidel was an avid sports fan, both rugby and football, in particular the mighty Gor Mahia and Arsenal. He'd walk from the house to Nyayo Stadium when Mom would refuse to drop him when we were young. Luam, thank you for bringing Fidel's life, heart, soul, and strength. Thank you for continuing Fidel and Odinga's family light. Thank you for being the light that you are. We'll stand with you and we'll walk with you. We'll forever nurture and protect his legacy in the person that is his son, Ali Raila Odinga. Fidel, you left large shoes to be filled, literally. But we promise to continue carrying the torch and finishing the race. Hatari, Dinov, Mandivdi, Obange, Gagolo, we will miss you. We'll miss your big hugs. We'll always love you. Mama Gibaba, Kikuyang, Ningikwe, Wonyagem.
I think you can see the emotions with which Junior has talked. And this is because Junior was very close to Fidel. They were not only relatives, but they were also friends. I don't want to say much, because much has been said. And in fact, most of the notes which I had taken to talk about the previous speakers have mentioned more or less all of them. What I want to emphasize is that Fidel was a bridge, not only between our family and our friends across the tribes, but also our adversaries. Fidel never knew any boundaries, and he tried to bring people together. That attribute to Fidel, I think it's something which we must emphasize, because we have lost a jewel. Fidel was actually amongst our nephews the best that I can talk about, because he had love, he had passion for relations. He knew all our relatives, and he visited them personally. And whenever there was any funeral or any of them was sick, Fidel was by their sides. Therefore, Fidel's funeral is unlike any other that we are going to see in our family in the recent years. In fact, in our family, I can only compare Fidel's funeral with that of our father, the late Jaramogi Oginga. And this is not because he had reached the status of Oginga Odinga, but because of the short time he was alive. People knew Fidel in his own way. Some people think that Fidel is being mourned because he's the son of Raila Amolo Odinga. I can tell you that Fidel, in very many ways, is being mourned on his own account and record. Because we know Fidel. Thank you. because we know Fidel was a friend and a companion of very many. To many people, Fidel was the son of the Prime Minister. To many people, Fidel was a philanthropist, because I participated in very many Harambees. Whenever I called him and told Fidel, asked Fidel, "Fidel, can you accompany me to this or that function?" He would tell me, "Uncle, I'm sorry, that date is not convenient for me, but take this money and do whatever you like with it. You can call my name, mention my name, or just make it one of your contributions." But he would definitely always respond. And in many occasions he accompanied me, and Fidel contributed very, very generously. Politically, a lot of people in politics, when they see a generous person contributing, they always associate that man with the ambition to succeed them, particularly those who are sitting in the seats of MPs. They don't like people who are coming to do some social function. But I must tell them that development and supporting people is a function which cannot be carried out only by one group of people or only by one individual. It is a collective responsibility, and people must be allowed freely to do it the way Fidel has been doing it. Fidel was a sportsman. He was everything to us. And whoever, if the death of Fidel, which to us as a family, has remained mysterious, because postmortem was done, and we are told as yet the cause of death of Fidel cannot be established. And if the death of Fidel was a natural death, so be it. But if the death of Fidel was from a human hand, I want to tell the person who did it that he really calculated and hit us below the belt. And I hope, of course, our family is not in the business of revenging, but I hope God, the Almighty, will revenge on our behalf. As I said, I didn't want to say a lot of what has been said before, but I just want the death of Fidel not to go for nothing. And therefore, I'm appealing to the political leadership of our country, both our coalition and the coalition which is in government, to use this Fidel's death, because I can see the president and the deputy president have been together with us. And occasions sometimes like this are the ones which bring people together. The vice president had mentioned it, and I hope that the death of Fidel will unite this country, and from now on, what we missed previously, which is called dialogue, will start. Thank you very much. Now I would like to invite Mama Aida to now come and mourn her beloved son and say a word or two. Can please Mama Aida come with Mama with Rosie? Where is Rosie? Yeah.
see the president and the deputy president. Our family and friends. Good afternoon. You've been sitting there not saying a word, but I'll give you an opportunity at least to open your mouth and say good afternoon. I'm here to mourn or to say something about my firstborn child, Fidel Castro Odhiambo Makarios Odinga. As a mother, I can tell you, the happiest day of my life was the day I gave birth to Fidel at Mater Misericordia Hospital on that second day of November 1973. When the baby was born, I held the baby in my hand and can tell you that's the most beautiful baby I've ever seen. I knew he was going to be tall because he was this long. He was the longest child, baby, that was born, that was in the nursery at that particular time. He looked very, very nice. And the looks are still there. You can see that smile. As a growing child, I thought Fidel was being spoiled by the father. I'm a teacher. I was a teacher. The father is an engineer. But I felt that as a teacher, I had to bring up my child in a certain way. The father, being an engineer, also had his own ideas. I knew I had to instill discipline and teach him the right values in life. But the father wanted to make him an engineer. And I remember when Fidel was about 3 years old, they went alone, the two of them, to buy toys for Fidel. And the father, he came back with three large cartons of toys. I could not believe it. And all these toys were electrical train. All of them were train moving around stations and so forth. And I said, why this? And he told me, because I want the boy to be an engineer. It never happened. Fidel had his own ideas. Fidel was a very loving child. As the sibling has said, he was loving to all our relatives and particularly very protective, even to me. I remember one time, Fidel, because he was growing tall very fast, at the age of 15, 13, Fidel was already approaching 5 feet 7 inches. And he thought that strength goes with age. And therefore, at that age, he developed love for football. I know they've talked about football here again. And his best team, as usual, was Gor Mahia. I used to be a very worried mother whenever Saturday and Sunday came and Gor Mahia were playing in this city. Because whatever I do, Fidel will hide and sneak and go to there. Nyayo National Stadium to watch Gor Mahia play. I remember one particular time Gor Mahia was playing against AFC Leopard. And you know what that means, those of you who are familiar with the games in this country. And of course, as usual, the war broke out. By 7 o'clock, I had not seen my child. 8 o'clock, I had no idea where he was. And we were told that some people were injured, some who had even died, and at the city mortuary.
I didn't know whether to start looking for him at Kenyatta National Hostel or at the city mortuary. But fortunately, he managed to walk to my sister's house, and my sister called me and said, "Your son is here." It was a relief. So Fidel and football is something that is carried out. Just as I say that I had my ideas of teaching good values, I'm going faster because I also want to give a chance to others to say something. When Fidel was reached 18 years old, and he said, "Mom, now I'm the age of majority. I'm 18 years old, and I want to go to a nightclub." I had a shock, and I told Fidel, looked around and said, "Yes, I'll allow you to go. But who are you going with?" I said, "I'll look for somebody who goes to nightclubs to take you along with him." And he said he had his friends. And I gave him two pieces of advice. The first one, I gave him money. And I told him, "If you want to drink soda in the nightclub, here's the money. Buy your own soda. Don't depend on somebody else to do it for you." The second advice was that you are going to meet young girls in that place. Remember, girls are not toys to play with. Respect them. You've got to respect them for being there. Those are the things that I taught my child. Fidel, as I said, loved me. He loved his father. Amongst all the four of them, Fidel's the only one who calls me mommy up to the time when he left us. The rest call me mom, and mom to me sounds like I need to pay attention. But Fidel said mommy, then that means nice. I hear, I know that something nice is going to follow. Fidel has left a young family. At the age of 41, Fidel has passed on. My own father died at the age of 41. What a coincidence. And when my father died, I thought that was the end of our life, but we are here. So Luam, my daughter-in-law, you can make it, and you will make it. The short time that you lived with Fidel, you've learned a lot of things from Fidel. You know Fidel's likings and dislikings. And some of the things that Fidel loved, these are the things that you are going to instill in your little boy, Alai Raila Odinga. Before I finish, I want to thank all the friends and relatives who have been with us during this particular time. In this modern time, news spread very far. And very fast. 30 minutes after Fidel had passed on, I got a call from Australia, and somebody was saying, "Polly." I got a call from Canada. I got a call from many other friends. I know many parents have been come home to be with us. Many have sent messages of condolences through letters, telephones, SMS, WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, and all the means that they can use. I've received them all, and thank you very much for them. The darkest day of my life was the day that 4th 4th January 2015. That's the day Fidel passed on. But Fidel has not left us without memories or without. He has not left us. He has left us with a beautiful wife. That is our daughter. We are going to look after you. We are going to love you. And you are Odinga, and that's what you remain. Fidel has left us with a beautiful young boy called Alai Raila Odinga, which is just a duplicate of Fidel, except for the color, which he inherited from the mother. So we thank God that we have part of Fidel remaining on this earth, and that's the part we are going to measure. Maybe before I invite my daughter-in-law, I think the two have conspired and said she'll speak somewhere else. But before I finish, I'd like to invite my daughter-in-law because she wants to say something about her husband. Luam.
I'd like to begin by thanking everybody for being here. It's touching to see the number of people here because Fidel didn't like sleeping alone. Even when he took naps, it was always with people around him in the living room. I'd like to share a letter that I've written for Fidel. My love, where do I even begin? I'll read it on her behalf. My love, where do I even begin? A few years ago, I met my six-foot Prince Charming. He became the love of my life, my best friend, the best father to our son, Alai, truly God's gift to me and many. Your generous spirit will go a long way. I've seen it, love, from the flow of guests to our home and messages of love from across the globe. You defied all preconceptions. You made me laugh when I didn't have a reason. You awed me with your wisdom. You melted my heart with your kindness. Your dedication to your people and country was so absolute and real. Always the optimist and ever selfless, gave of yourself for the sake of your friends. I promise to take care of our little prince and keep the culture alive for Alai and teach him Kitgi Kitimbi, Luo way. The swiftness of your departure remains shocking for me, but I cannot question God. He called you home, and now I must trust that the living God who gave you to me will look after us. Through my grief, the memories will shine bright, my love. Thank you for those amazing years. A lifetime would never have been enough. Till we meet again, my love, my husband.
Thank you very much for listening to us, and may Fidel's soul, may God put Fidel's soul in eternal peace till we meet again. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ida. Now, I want to take this opportunity to invite Fidel's father, who was not just a father, but a very great friend of Fidel. I think Fidel
a lot of people thought was going to be the heir to Raila. I always asked Fidel whether he was going to join politics, but he told me, no, Uncle, I'm still not decided whether to join politics or not. And I know it is with a very heavy heart. Raila has been hit, I think, more than anyone because of his closeness with Fidel. He will tell you the story, and I want to now invite him to come and say a word or two.
Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I feel very delighted to see all of you here this afternoon. And I want to begin by thanking everybody for taking time to come and share this moment with us as a family. Many friends from all over the world have called. Some have written messages of condolences from all over, and we thank all of them. I have amongst us here a friend who, when he heard about this, and he called me yesterday and told me that he was going to try to be here today. And truly enough, he's here. I have here Ambassador Charles Teeth, who's flown all the way from Boston, Massachusetts, to be here with us. Thank you, brother. Thank you. One writer, one Mae West, once said that you only live once, but if you live it right, once is enough. So we have had Fidel has lived with us once, and has, but has lived also wisely. And therefore, it is enough. What we need to do is to celebrate his life. Many people have spoken very lofty words and paid tribute to Fidel. And therefore, it cannot be that every one of them is lying. At least some of them are saying the truth. You heard so many names mentioned here. The only one they did not mention is called Hatari. But you see, when Fidel was born and young, he was staying in Nairobi West, at a flat in Nairobi West. Remember that flat up to now. And we had a big drum. And Fidel, as a baby, used to run around that drum. And at that time, Kenya had just come from Olympic Games in Munich. And Kipchoge Keino had done so well in those Olympics. So Fidel would run around the drum and he'd call him Kipchoge. Kipchoge. Kipchoge, we used to cheer him that way. Later on, Rosemary would run around the same drum. This time it was Rono, who was now the king of athletics at that time. But Fidel, of course, was a very cheerful child, as they have said. People have been asking, why did you name your child Fidel Castro? That is a question that has been asked several times. And then now you have Fidel Castro, then you had Odinga, then you had Macarius. Three very heavy names. And I've been explaining that. And that when Fidel was born at that time, that was the height of the Cold War. And the United States was engaged in a very bitter war in Vietnam. Vietnam War was raging, and many people around the world actually felt that America was actually the aggressor in Vietnam. And in those days, you're looking for somebody who stood up to America. And that time, it was Fidel Castro. So it is not, this Fidel did not give himself the name. He found himself carrying the name Fidel Castro. You know, Fidel Castro, of course, has got very many powerful enemies. So there are some enemies he inherited merely because he was carrying the name Fidel Castro. Likewise, the name Odinga also can be a blessing and also a curse. So there's many friends he made because he was an Odinga, and many friend enemies he made because he was an Odinga. You know, like I know that my brother president has very many enemies because he carried the name Kenyatta, and many friends also because of the same reason. And then Macarius. Now, but Fidel actually carried this with grace, and he was a very young and humble person who was very unassuming. Mark Antony, I have not come to praise Fidel. I just wanted to say that Fidel was not only married to Luam. Fidel had a first wife, as you saw in the eulogy. She was called Shiru. I don't know that Shiru is present. Shiru is there. There she is. Shiru is there. Comes from Kiambu, and we have Adonis also from Kiambu. I don't know, there some of them are in the crowd here. So Fidel knew how to walk above the bridges and bring people together. Fidel did not actually know anything about a tribe. So when they had a disagreement with Shiru, they did a very similar thing. They said that they wanted to part, and it was a very similar parting. Then I told him, once burnt, twice shy. So you must now look carefully. Then he came back to tell me that, this time I'm going outside the country. Going outside our borders. Then she came with Luam and said, this is the lady now that I want to marry. When she brought Luam, the condition was that he must convert to the Greek Orthodox Church. So Fidel said that if conversion to the Orthodox is all that I need to pay, it's a very small price to pay to get a wife. So he agreed, and we went to the Greek Orthodox Church on Gong Road, and Bishop Macarius, who is going to talk to shortly, actually baptized him, the name Macarius. So that's how he became Fidel Castro Odhiambo Macarius Odinga at that time. And then we did this wedding. And they have lived very closely together with Luam. I have my in-laws here. The father is also here. Ms. Bekele is a very celebrated architect. Deritu Bekele is down here, my brother-in-law. He's one of the most celebrated architects in this region. And one of those who actually participated in the design of the Kenyatta International Conference Center. Right now he's practicing in Kampala. So we are very happy to have this relationship with our in-laws there, and I do not want today to make a long speech, just to welcome you here, because I know that you've sat here for a very long time. We are going to be going to Bondo, and I hope to welcome most of you down there in Bondo once again. Our people say that you don't get drunk in your party. So I'm not going to get drunk today in my party. I would like to now invite my brother, President Honorable Uhuru Kenyatta, to come and pay his tribute here.
Ndugu Raila Odinga, Mama Aida, Duam, familia yote ya ndugu yetu Fidel Castro Odinga, mine first and foremost is to once again take this opportunity to join you, my brother, and Mama Aida, and the whole family in condoling you on my own behalf, on behalf of my wife, and indeed on behalf of the entire Kenyatta family. We have lost a great son, and we are here to share this moment of grief and pain with you. I am also here in my own personal capacity as a friend of Fidel's, a man who I respected. And indeed, as has been stated here, a man who knew how to cross the political divide, the ethnic divide, the religious divide, a man who bore no grudges, a man who had no bitterness, a man who could easily congratulate you on the one hand and be your competitor on the other. And life would continue. He bore no grudges. I remember severally, especially when we shared a building at the Treasury, when he would come via my office on his way to see his father, and we would talk about many issues. As I was telling his father only recently, the beginning of December, he called me and he told me that he wanted us to meet, and I told him, yes, let's find some time to get together. Unfortunately, that never came to pass. But let me say that as we mourn this friend, as we share today as a nation united by grief, I think there is a lot we can learn from the life that Fidel led. A lot that we can learn that can help us heal and unite our country. And as we are here today, joined together in grief, I strongly believe that through his life, we can also join together in life and make this country a much better place for all our citizens. I think the key for me fact that it is indeed possible for us to have a one Kenyan nation as we see here today. It is possible. And the onus is on all of us as leaders to see how we can bring that about. To ensure a better Kenya for all our people. And I want to give you my assurance that I am personally willing and I have no issue whatsoever in sitting down and talking and bringing people together. This is no problem. All we need to understand is that we need one another. And we need less of shouting at one another and more of talking with one another. Talking with one another. And that was what Fidel was very good at. He could move away from the shouting and be able to engage and talk with you. And that's how people build relations. That's how people build respect for one another. And that's how great things happen. So let us, like Fidel, learn to talk with each other and less talk at one another. And we can make some tremendous progress. Today is not mine to say much. We are here, as I said, to mourn a friend and to join my brother and his family in mourning a son. We stand with you. And like I said, when we have been engaging all along, on my own behalf and on behalf of the entire government of the Republic of Kenya, I promise you we will follow to the end until we establish exactly what happened to our brother Fidel. May the Almighty God rest his soul in eternal peace. And to Luam, we are as open to you as we were to Fidel. And whatever it is that you may wish of us, never for 1 minute hesitate. Know that we are your older brothers and we are there for you whenever you need us. May God bless you and keep you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very, very much for all your tributes to Fidel. We now start to have the second part of this service, which is a church service, and we promise that it will be shorter as we bring this to a conclusion. Just to reflect on the many things that have been said, I want us to be quiet now and ask the All Saints Cathedral choir.